Thank you. Thanks a lot. Mr. Ron Miles on the trumpet, Ron Miles. Mr. Kent McClain on the bass, Kent McClain. Mr. Chris Lee on the drums, Chris Lee. Mrs. Judge that's on the piano, Judge Jenkins. It's a tune I wrote and a tune that the band wrote. Put one right after the other. The first one was inspired by actually someone that is a setting of the beginning of Rilke's first duinology, which is kind of about the power of beauty and things beyond our understanding and how that might actually be more terrifying than we imagine it actually is. And then followed by Kurt Cobain's or Nirvana's, if you will, Smells Like Teen Spirit, which if you weren't a high schooler in the 90s, well, you missed out. Just tell you that now. That was some good music. Next, we're going to play another one of these kind of jazz art song settings, but I'm not going to sing this evening, so you don't need to leave now. And this next piece is the last paragraph on the road. So, which I have a good friend, he's a really big jazz fan, his name's Peter Poses, and I don't think he's heard that, but he drives up and down the Front Range, he does a radio show up here on I guess you call it Friday mornings, midnight to whatever time of the morning, and he comes to a lot of shows down in Denver. We were talking about Kerouac and On the Road, because I was reading that at the time, and he said, oh, the last paragraph of that is one of the most beautiful things ever written, and so I always remember that, and I always wanted to do something with that. So I sat down and wrote it all out in kind of the style of an Ornette Coleman tune, something like Capital Gray, if you're familiar with Ornette's music. So it's in the program if you want to follow along. You don't have to follow along. You'll still be a good person if you don't, but if you want to, it's in there. And so this is, I think, a Dean Moriarty. Thank you. bit of a mouthful to explain, so I'll keep it brief. But basically, I wanted to start writing things about when I felt frustrated in life, or sad, or happy, or whatever. When I was feeling too much of something, I just needed a reminder that we're all the same thing. So I started writing these songs about the idea that we're all just a dream of ourselves, and that we're really just one giant thing in this universe. And so this first one is called Dream Yourself Alone. So the great thing about being a music professor is you get to work and collaborate with a lot of the other professors. It's not just like you go and you teach your class and you do your research and you go home. You play with people you work with, you see students all the time, you work with ensembles, you walk down the hall, and you say hi to people, and I'm grateful for that. But there's still a lot of time you spend sitting in your office in front of the machine, as I say, you know, doing the machine's bidding. And it can feel really lonely after a while. And then when you sit down to write music, you're doing that by yourself. And then you sit down to practice and you're doing that by yourself. You spend an immense amount of time by yourself. And it can be really crushing sometimes, you know, all this time you spend by yourself. But it can also be kind of fulfilling too, just to be at peace and just say, I'm okay by myself, I don't need everyone else to justify my existence. So anyway, so I wrote this song. This song comes out of sitting in my office by myself, if you want to know what that is. And just the monotony of the clock, just ticking, 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 and the kind of hopefulness of feeling independence, but also kind of the crushing. So this is called Dream of Self Alone. Thank you. Thanks for that. And now this next one is kind of not exactly the opposite. It is a very different reception. The other thing you are when you're music professors, you're doing a lot of stuff all the time. And when you don't have things to do, you find more things to do. Because you don't know why you don't have things to do, and you need to make sure you have stuff to do all the time. More stuff you have to do is that, and if you can write it down. But anyway, stuff to do. So there's some, a little bit of justifying your existence through activity. And I was definitely feeling this, you know, over the course of the last couple of years. And so this tune is about that. This is called Man of Action, or sometimes called Dream of Self in Motion. So,
thank you. Thank you.
This next one is written for Charlie, my son Charlie, who's over there. He's not so fiery of spirit right now. He looks kind of drowsy. But Charlie has a green dragon kite. It's a giant kite, it's a big black kite, it has a ferocious Asian-looking green dragon on it, and it's awesome. And on blustery days, much like today, Charlie would like to take it out and fly across the sky. But really, if you've ever seen Charlie in action, and you've seen this kite in action, you would understand why this next tune is for him. And so anyway, to the sleepy child, O.D., this is the green dragon.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Before we get to the last two, I just want to thank these guys for coming and introduce them all. These are all guys, they're just such fantastic musicians, and I've been listening to them since I was like 19 or so. And then, in fact, hearing them play like in these exact groups at that age, it's just such an honor and privilege to get to play with them here. It's really very special to me. So thanks for them for coming. So this last tune is going with the dream theme for the night. This is one of my favorite Billy Strayhorn tunes. This is called Daydream.
Thank you.